Alaikum. Today's date is July 24.
Let's get from the record.
وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله لا نحصي ثناء عليه. هو سبحانه وتعالى كما أثنى على نفسه. الحمد لله عدد خلقه وزنة عرشه وكمال كلماته. قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن أيما تدعوا فله الأسماء الحسنى. ولا تجهر بصلاتك ولا تخافت بها وابتغي بين ذلك سبيلا. وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل. وكبره تكبيرا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده القاهر فوق عباده. إليه يرجع الأمر كله والله بما يعملون محيط. ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم عبد الله ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة. يا أيها الرسول، بلغ ما أنزل إليك من ربك، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين. من يطع الله ورسوله وأولي الأمر من المؤمنين فلا مضل له، ومن يعص الله ورسوله وأولي الأمر من المؤمنين فلا هادي له. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، brothers and sisters who share the divine commitment of prioritizing Allah subhanahu in your lives and belittling everything and anyone besides Allah jalla wa ala in your lives. In His care for our responsibility in this life, has described to us the general climate of which we discover new altitudes and new dimensions the more we become adherent and subjects of His orders and of His guidelines. In the creation of ourselves into this life as transitory as it is by nature, He has told us in a dialogue that took place with the formulation of this life and the subsequent chapters, one of which we are witnessing today, that a shaitan, the avowed enemy of human beings and of Allah's program for human life, this avowed enemy of Allah and man said, أَرَأَيْتَ هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَّمْتَ عَلَيْهِ لَأَحْتَنِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَّتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. A shaitan is saying to his creator and our creator, you see, this creature which you have honored beyond myself, I shall become part of his posterity. I shall become part of his life. It is a fact which is stated for our attention before our particular lifespan began, so that we may take notice of the way this shaitan implements his methods, as subtle as they are, in the world around us. And then listen to Allah's response. وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ وَاجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَعِدْهُمْ وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. Allah, as He created this erratic being into our lives, was aware of the mechanisms that were to be utilized by this shaitan. And so He responded, opening our eyes to the tactics that were to be applied by this evil creation. وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ. Intimidate and entice any of them to which you have access. وَاسْتَفْزِزْ بِصَوْتِكَ مَنْ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ. And then the mechanism that you are going to use to entice and intimidate them is going to be the means of audio communication. The way a shaitan, using his instruments of voice or sound, to impress those who come under his sway, has been exposed to us prior to our taking on the obligations in which he comes to figure in. And these obligations are accentuated today as we see him
full blast with the instruments that are available to him, from the media all the way down to the loose cannon and the barrage of bombarding the senses of those who come under the shaitan's sway. واستفزز بصوتك من استطعت منهم. The condition here is those who you are able to bring under your spell. واستفزز بصوتك من استطعت منهم. واجلب عليهم بخيلك ورجلك وشاركهم في الأموال والأنفس وعدهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا. And then try to use your glitter and your fanfare, the most prestigious that you have, to offer these subjects in their lifespan, as they were created to carry out and fulfill the promise and the covenant that has been related to them in the very nature of my bringing them into existence. وَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ. And khayl, the word that is erroneously translated and incorrectly reproduced as being horses, it is not that. Al-khayl is the means of transportation and the backbone of the military that are a form of arrogance and bigotry and false pride. وَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ. And all the manpower that you can muster, and you can see that at the disposal of this evil mechanism in life, and the way a shaitan works his way into human thinking, there is many of that at his disposal. وَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ. وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَعِدْهُمْ. And then become part of their own selves, part of their own possessions, part of their own souls, and part of their own propriety in this world. And then give them promises, fool them by drawing them into the false pretenses that you make for them, because all of this amounts to nothing except an inflation of their ego. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. Indeed, my subjects, you have no authority over them, and it is enough for Allah to be the source in which they have their confidence and their reliance, to whom they are attached and allied. But the shaitan, in his influence and spell over his subservients, they go ahead only to be deserted by these false impressions and these false ideas during the hours of confrontation. This is when a shaitan will give up his association with them, and he will have nothing to do with that final moment when truth comes to face falsehood. وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ. At that moment and at that time, وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ. At that moment and at that time, إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا. The array of forces that are ganging up, in reality and in essence, there is no substance to it. A shaitan and those who have become part of a shaitan and who the shaitan has become part of them, we have no instruments in gauging how this process takes place. The nature of the shaitan is one that is described by the Quran as a khannas, as a waswas, as a most subtle influence, as a susurration of human nature, that he has become part of these human beings that we witness with our eyes and we hear in their testimonies. وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ. And become part of their essence, part of their physical and their beyond physical existence, which he has become, and to which we witness in the persons and the characters that are applying the false promises of a shaitan. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. They shall come to see that what a shaitan is promising them is false from beginning to end. But they shall not come to see that in a process of verbal communication to them. This matter goes beyond the verbal communication between a few individuals. This matter and the ante of this matter has risen to the horizon of a social and systematic confrontation with the order of Allah. And this is what we see today. Vessels, an armada of the Navy, a fleet of the Air Force, and other forces that are assembled because they have been drawn in, they have been enticed by a shaitan, they have been lured into this war between al-Haqq and al-Batil. The troops and the soldiers of Allah, and then the mercenaries and the paid agents of who has been referred to very accurately as a shaitan al-Akbar. Let us take another scenario and assume that there are and frigates and destroyers that are assembled in the Gulf of Mexico. And they are using the Gulf of Mexico to escort hostile forces of the United States itself into Mexico, where a war has been going on for 7 years on the international lines, as they are dubbed, between the United States and Mexico. Would the United States, under the excuse, and it is a limping excuse indeed, tolerate such a brazen act of war against it? It is obvious that this is an outright act of war in at least a couple of definitions. The first definition is that these vessels that are passing through the Strait of Hormuz are subject, according to international law, which is the standard that they go by. We can't hold them to Islamic standards because they are not Muslims. We hold them to their own civilized standards. If international law gives the right for belligerents who are at war with each other to inspect what is called or referred to as neutral shipping or neutral cargo vessels, then why is the United States itself violating this neutrality? According to this so-called international law, these vessels, whether they are flagged with Old Glory or whether they are flagged with some other type of cloth, it doesn't matter. International law, the law that is subscribed to by the United Nations and the United States included, gives the right, in this case of one of the belligerent states, which is Iran, to take suspected cargo ships and then inspect what it is containing, if it is not containing any war material, to send it on its way, and if it is, to confiscate that material. But no, under the pretext of safeguarding international shipping, the United States is saying to international law itself, no, you don't have the right to inspect these ships. You have been inspecting them long enough. And our agent in Baghdad is hurting. He is beginning to collapse, and his regime. We cannot tolerate any more of this. We shall interject our own vessels to see to it that these ships are off limits to your inspections. This is a direct act of war against the Muslims, even using the standards of the Kafirs and the Mushriks themselves. The other act of war is that the United States administration does not want to accept an interchange with the Muslims as equal people with the rights and the honor that all human beings were born with. It is not superpowers who give honor to man. It is Allah who has bestowed upon man this honor. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. No, the United States does not agree that the Muslims should have a degree of dignity. It foresees that a triumph of the Muslim forces forces in that crucial part of the world will strangulate the economies and the industrialization upon which hundreds of millions of people have set their lives. It will force them to go back and reconsider their relationship with these people who happen to be Muslims, who happen to be in control of what has been called by them the choke point, or the artery, the jugular artery of the industrialized world, and then come to an understanding with these Muslims. Muslims who carry within them dignity, the dignity that was bestowed upon them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But no, how can we give Muslims dignity? How can we sit with Muslims talking to them on an equal basis? We have been in the past 100 years in the business of humiliating them. How can we now all of a sudden elevate them to the degree of humanity that we are sharing? No, to hell with the Muslims. This is the verbalization of the military act that has been taken by the administration of the Shaytan al-Akbar in conjunction with the minor demons and shayateen in Europe against the Muslims today. And once again, the Shaytan has drawn them into this hornet's nest. And if they want to be stung by the Muslims, and if they are liberally at ease to pick a fight with the Muslims, then they shall know that the Muslims have been exercising, they have been drilling and practicing for about 8 years now to take on the counterpart of the other shaitan in this world, who have been taken on in Afghanistan, to take them on in the Gulf, in the peninsula, in Southwest Asia, in the Middle East, and wherever they exist with their interests, and with them their colleagues, their collaborators, their agents, and their extensions throughout that area. This is the extent, and this is the purview of these kafirs. They want, they say, to have neutral shipping lanes in the Gulf. They are protecting the vessels of Kuwait. Why don't they protect? Because there are two sources of destruction upon vessels that are channeling the Gulf. One of them is Iraq, and the other one is Iran, in their own minds. Why are they selectively protecting some vessels and not protecting others? Why are they telling the Muslims and the leadership of the Muslims, why are they telling them that you cannot bother the ships that belong to one side? But they are not telling the other side the same idea and the same statement. Why aren't they saying to Iraq, you cannot bomb, strafe, missile these other ships? It is obviously an act of war against the Muslims. As much as they want to cushion this act, as much as they want to protect their intentions, as much as they want to conceal their objectives, the strategy is clear. They want to take on the Muslims, and the Muslims should welcome such a development, and the diplomats should give way now to the revolutionaries of Islam, to those who are seeking martyrdom, the diplomats should take the back seat and let now the language of the bullets and the language of the bombs, let them impress these kafirs, because it is the only language they understand. And it is what will cause the rupture between them and their source of false promises, the rupture between a shaitan and his allies on all levels, whether they are the kafirs and the munafiqs on one hand, or whether they are the internal makeup of the administration on the other hand, or anything in between them. They will break up and they will disintegrate. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانُ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: جاهدوا المشركين بأنفسكم وأموالكم وألسنتكم. صدق رسول الله. ادعوا الله سبحانه وأنتم موقنون بنصره. إن تنصروا الله ينصركم ويثبت أقدامكم. الحمد لله الذي هدى وصلى الله أقدامكم. الحمد لله الذي هدى وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه أولي النهى والتقى. وجاهدوا في الله حق جهاده هو اجتباكم. And struggle your utmost, including military conflict, the way you are guided and commanded to do. For he has given you the mandate to do so. This is an order not coming from Lieutenant so-and-so or from Captain so-and-so. This is an order coming from Allah. There are times where al-jihad becomes farbayn, which means an individual and a personal obligation on every Muslim. One of these times is the one in which the leadership of Islam is threatened and intimidated. And this is actually what is transpiring in front of us in our days today. Al-jihad madin ila yawm al-qiyamah. Jihad, as the Prophet said, is in a continuum until the day of resurrection. There is no period in which we come and say, there is no jihad today. Jihad is incumbent. Every one of us is duty bound as the developments are geared from one level to a higher one, day after day. Every one of us is duty bound to elevate his personal ideas and thinking to that level of jihad. If Muslims are struck in one area of the Ummah, it is as if and tantamount to the Muslims being struck in the other part of the Ummah. And it becomes our duty, it becomes our fulfillment to try with whichever means we have. Allah does not ask us to perfect the means of striking back. when the time comes, but he asks us to do so with whatever means we have when the time approaches. This is the frame of our thinking. If they want to activate the spirit of jihad against them, they shall come to realize what it means to be in the gun barrels of the Muslims wherever they are. This scheme or this smoke screen of terrorism that the Muslims use, as they call it, is not at all what they describe it to be. It is legitimate for Muslims to strike against these kafirs who are representatives and who are the extensions of a shaitan in their military or in their political guise. We are not here in the United States throwing bombs at them. We are not in the Gulf of Mexico. We cannot even be in the house of Allah. Who are the people who are using force and sheer force against our rights? They are the ones who should be rightfully described as the terrorists of this world. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Terrorism is the precursor to al-jihad. It is an indication when they say that they are terrorized that we are on the right path, because those who have taken advantage of other people for a long time, and these other oppressed people, once they begin to stand up for their rights and make their voices heard and take a position, that act by itself reverberates with shingles of terror in their hearts before using the instruments that are legitimately ours to use, because Allah has given them to us. When that time comes, when that hour approaches, we shall see what the true meaning of terror is. And we, with reliance upon Allah, we shall see to it that the will of Allah shall take its course. And if the will of Allah is that we meet our destiny in this process, we accept what Allah has cut out for us of this life and this lifespan. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barik lana fi ma a'tayt, wa qina sharra ma qadayt, fa innaka taqdi wa la yuqda alayk, wa innahu la yadhillu man walayt, wa la ya'izzu man adayt, tabarakta rabbana wa ta'alayt, falaka alhamdu ala ma qadayt, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa ali muhammad. اللهم انصرنا بالحق وانصر الحق بنا، اللهم كن معنا ولا تكن علينا، اللهم بك نحاول وبك نصاول وبك نقاتل، اللهم حبب إلينا الشهادة وزينها في قلوبنا، ربنا أنت ولينا وأنت ناصرنا، انصرنا على من عاداك، اللهم نصرك الذي وعدتنا، ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك، ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة، إنك لا تخلف الميعاد والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر سنريهم آياتنا في أنفسهم في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق ومن أظلم ممن منع مساجد الله أن يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها أولئك ما كان لهم أن يدخلوها إلا خائفين لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى أهلها وإذا حكمتم بين الناس أن تحكموا بالعدل إن الله نعما يعظكم به إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت.